It is party time, Mom. Welcome to another episode of the Chad Prather Show. Hope everybody is looking forward to a wonderful Thanksgiving. Now, I'm going to be real honest with you right now. We're going to get into some things about me today, about my life. Lisa Paige is here to help me do it. You're going to be my psychoanalyst.
Okay. I'm the perfect person for this episode.
You really are. You really are. I have to call you out. You have Invisalign.
Why?
Right, I have to call you out.
This is so bad. If I speak with a lisp.
Because people are going to be like,
you know why?
You sound like Elijah Schaefer.
Do I need to take these out for this episode?
No, leave them in. We're going to get comfortable. I just figure if I got to expose myself, I'm going to expose you too.
Well, that makes sense.
My favorite person, Kayla, and Super Mario Chris Cruz driving us into the nether regions of all things my insanity. I'm glad you guys are here. We got a lot of stuff coming up. Go to watchchad.com. That's where the fun stuff is. I want you to come see us in Schulenburg, Texas. That's going to be next Sunday. That is the Sunday after Thanksgiving. Okay, so when you're all done with your family and you want to get out, have some fun here, have some laughs, sing some songs, come see us. We're going to be there in Schulenburg, Texas. Watchchad.com has all the info. And then December 10th, I'm going to be in Vidor, Texas. Some people say, where is Vidor, Texas? That is near Beaumont. So we're going to be there, and then we're going to be in Arlington Music Hall. That's our Christmas special.
I'm coming.
Chad Prather and friends.
Coming.
Hopefully the sound system works better than it did last time when we were at Arlington Music Hall, because damn, dude was sitting over there watching a Rangers game on his phone the whole time we were trying to do a show instead of doing his sound. And I'm like, golly, man. You know, at any time you want to deal with this monitor that's not working up here. Anyway, people are funny. And then on the, we're going to finish out, as far as I know, that we're going to finish out the year in Houston on the 19th. And then I always have my New Year's party. Typically do it on New Year's Day. We'll see. You know, last year we had our big soiree, our invitation to our New Year's party. Last year we were going to have Tracy Lawrence was going to come and play and sing, but Tracy... let's just say he got ill with something that we do not know what it was. Flu-like symptoms. So Tracy didn't come.
He's a no-show. Okay.
But we had Casey James, who was, of course, from American Idol, an incredible musician. He came and played with us. I don't know who we'll have this year's party. But Chad Prather's New Year party, New Year's Day party, is the bomb.
Bomb.com.
My life has changed a lot, Lisa. We're going to talk about that in this episode. This is going to be this is going to be a come to Jesus episode for Chad Prather. For those of you who want to talk about woke mobs and cancel culture and all of that, and maybe we'll allude to it later in the show. But I want to talk about me. You know why? Because this show is aptly named the Chad Prather Show. Yeah.
A lot of questions.
Lots of questions.
Surrounding you lately.
People ask. I'll answer. Today I'm going to answer. I wish we had an ability like to take questions. And that's the thing about when Elijah and Sydney do their You Are Here show. They can actually see, they're doing it live, so they see the YouTube Super Chat. But that would probably just piss me off. Because people say the dumbest stuff.
Yeah. Yeah, you can't filter or go through them before.
And it's amazing how you just gravitate towards the negative stuff. Mm-hmm. Anyway. I'm trying not to do that. But in full disclosure, we are pre-taping this episode. So if, you know, here lately you've been seeing me look all skinny and svelte. Now it's Fat Chad suddenly again.
That's not true. Have an Oreo.
Because we're going to dig into the Oreos. We're going to start the Christmas season with my favorite thing on the planet. That is white chocolate covered Oreos. And you brought me a box.
Well, I don't think that these white chocolate covered Oreos are out all year. So when
They're
I
not.
Saw them, I said, I got to get these for Chad.
They are the best.
They are limited edition.
I don't eat a lot of sweets. Every now and then I go through a phase where I just want something.
Right.
And that phase just lasts, you know, for a minute. And then I'm on to the next. But we're gonna eat some of these because I can't be around.
I can't. I got this Invisalign.
You got Invisalign in.
Can't do
and
it.
You're fat.
Stop. I feel like when I laugh, these pop out.
I love calling skinny people fat, right? Just like, you're funny.
Me and my fupa.
It's funny because you're fat.
Me and my fupa. Wearing my mom jeans.
Do you guys wonder, like, in your head when Lisa says things, if she even knows what that means?
I know what it means. I saw it on a TikTok video, okay?
Oh, my gosh. Oh, well, let's get into it, but let's take a break.
Oh, first. Do we?
Yeah, we're going to.
Getting excited.
After the break. Hey, we spend one third of our lives in bed. So pure organic cotton sheets from Bolin Branch make a truly special gift. They make the highest quality sheets by doing things the right way, not the easy way. The gift everyone wants is a better night's sleep. Bolin Branch never disappoints with the highest quality sheets, blankets, pillows, and throws, plus their holiday packaging makes your gift look and feel special. Personal endorsement, I'll tell you about it right now. I sleep on it. Well, when the thing rolls up and it says personal endorsement, I'm going to tell you my personal endorsement. I sleep on them every night. I mean, if the president can sleep, and like the last five presidents have had Bolin Branch sleeps, if they could sleep on them.
Joe Biden obviously is sleeping on them.
Lisa trying to laugh with her mouth closed.
I can't. I was just going to say, Joe Biden obviously is sleeping on these sheets because he's asleep.
I love them. I bought them. And then when Bolin Branch became a sponsor, they sent me
a
set.
Go figure.
So I have, I don't know, about four sets of Bolin Branch sheets. They sent me one. I bought three. And I don't advertise anything I don't believe in. And I do believe in good night's sleep. Bolin Branch was started by husband and wife team Scott and Missy Tannen. They wanted to create a new standard in bedding by doing things the right way and not the easy way. They hold themselves to a huge high standard across the board, from sourcing pure organic cotton to putting workers' rights first. And it's not just their sheets that are made the right way. Their pillows, bath towels, their robes, everything too. They've got these signature hemmed sheets that are beautiful. They're bestsellers for them, and there's for a reason. Every time you wash them, they get softer. So treat yourself and your loved ones to the new standard in bedding from Bolin Branch. Their gifts come wrapped and ready in their special holiday packaging. Order by 12/19 for guaranteed delivery by Christmas. Best deals of the year going on now. Today is your last day with promo code WATCHCHAD at bolandbranch.com. Promo code WATCHCHAD. Exclusions may apply. We'll be right back. So I was sitting here during the break, and I got a text message from Steve Helms, the Texas legend Steve Helms. And Steve only texts me for one of three reasons. Let's drink.
let's eat.
Or do we have any new shows booked? In other words, when am I getting paid? So he just texted me, let's drink. And I sent him a picture like this of the camera to tell him basically I'm in the studio. And the clock said 7.5 minutes. He said, 7.5 minutes, that's a long time to wait. And he could see your leg. He goes, let's see the hot chick. So I turned over and I took a picture of you who were looking at your phone there during the break.
Thank you.
You're very welcome. And with your Invisaligns. And he said, she's wearing my shirt, which says lover. You had to look. I had to look.
I know. Last time I checked, it was from Pistola.
Yeah. I think he thinks he's a lover.
That's cute.
And then he texted back. He said, bitch is thinking about me.
That's right. Always.
No, she's not. So anyway, therapy. I'm almost 49 years old. 49 years old. I think I'm doing okay.
I think you're doing great.
I think I'm doing okay for 49.
Yeah.
I mean, I'm not making Glenn Beck money. But I'm working on it. I work hard.
I can't take you serious when you're eating a sleeve of Oreos right now.
Well, you know what? Everything goes better with a cookie, right? So I'm just going to pop these little Oreos out.
Sure.
And, you know, my birthday, so it comes up December 9th.
Mm-hmm.
Venmo me at Chad Prather 22. Actually, I don't know what my Venmo is. But just since I said it out loud, I'm going to go ahead and look it up.
Better check it.
It actually is Chad Prather 22.
Okay.
Funny. And,
are those good?
So good.
I bet you they're even better cold. Refrigerated.
Oh my God, this is so good.
Mm-hmm.
So good. Like, I didn't even expect it to be that good.
Because it's been a year since you've had them?
I hate you right now.
I wish I could have one, but these damn trays.
They hurt?
They'd be killing me. No, they're just uncomfortable. And you cannot You can't eat with them. That's a
no-no.
How long
do you have to wear them?
Thankfully, only 3 months.
But I mean, you take them in and out, right?
Yeah, when you eat. But they're not just like, you know, when you have a retainer and you just click it out with your mouth.
You have beautiful teeth.
Well, there's a couple little things that I need to switch up.
God, that's vain.
Oh, beauty is pain, Chad. I'll talk to you in February.
Oh?
One of these are off.
Oh, I thought you were getting boobs or something.
I wouldn't even look. I would not even look right with boobs. Real big boobs.
That'd be weird to me.
Boobs. Just boobs.
You've said it. Enough.
Boobs. Booms, as my son used to call them.
Boons.
Booms.
Yeah. Or as my 8-year-old cousin used to say to his mom, hey, come over here behind the door so I can get something to eat.
Oh, gross.
Time's flying. Like, not only does time fly more the older you get, but like we're just bombarded with things mm-hmm. that come our way, right?
Mm-hmm.
So last year, I jumped into this whole governor race, right? I was the first one to get into it. I said I was going to do it, and I started July 2nd, 2020. Now, here we are, a year and a half later. There's, you know, they want to say that the primary election is going to be held the first week in March, which is what it was originally scheduled for. December 13th is the filing deadline for whoever's going to run. So I'm sure there'll be a lot of people who will jump in all of these statewide races on December 13th. And we'll see. And there'll be, of course, there'll be litigation that's around the redistricting of the House seats and things like that in the state. And because of those litigation that'll come, you know, people suing over that, they may delay this primary election. I hope they don't. I would love for it to be in March, just simply because, full disclosure, I'm tired.
Yeah.
I'm tired. Like, I have mission accomplished, busted my ass trying to help people understand what's going on in the state of Texas. Mm-hmm. And also bring awareness to the people that are representing them. Bring awareness to the people about the people who are representing them, supposedly. And hopefully made some light bulbs go off. Now, I love when I say that because, you know, some troll the other day said, well, the light bulb might go off, but it's only a 7.5-watt bulb with your people. So, you know, needless to say, it's been a lot. And I got a great email the other day, which, by the way, go to watchchad.com and register your email address so that I can talk to you.
I got your email yesterday.
Did you?
Just checking up on you.
I wrote it on the toilet.
So good. Great. Yeah. Oh, nice.
And I'm writing. I'm writing these emails, mm-hmm. right? I'm sending them out at least one a week. I'm writing a little mm-hmm. note.
Yeah.
And so people, sometimes I will actually include my one of my email addresses so I'll get responses. Because when you send out 100,000 emails, somebody's going to hit reply.
Yeah.
All right. So I get some of the replies back. Not always, because not every email campaign is going to have my address mm-hmm. on there. Because I just can't. I get inundated. So here's one that came back. Chad, you're a fraud, and your stuff is made in China.
Okay.
You're no country boy, nor are you country or cowboy. That was reasonably redundant. You have no idea what it means to love our country. So far, you have 2 strikes against you at proving me wrong. I don't know what all that means, but that was the like, you're no country boy. Okay. I mean, like, boy, way to come at me hard, bruh.
Yeah, bruh's been watching you because he obviously knows a lot about you. These people.
Well, that's why I do it. I just do it for all of the fun stuff and the accolades. And
the content. The content, you know, in and of itself.
Just, and it's one big popularity contest yep. for me. It's publicity stunt. I'm just in it to get rich, mm-hmm. you know. That's what I'm doing. So, as many of you who are paying attention, if you've been paying attention, you've been close to the show, you either know, if you know me, you know, or you have assumed it, I went through a divorce. All right.
Dun, dun, dun!
And, you know, divorce is the saddest business in the world, right? It really is. And needless to say, it's expensive to deal with it. Anything legal is expensive to deal with. And I don't want to go into any details there because it's nobody's business, but it was a long process. It was a long time coming. You know, everybody's at fault. Nobody's innocent when it comes to a deal like that. Mm-hmm. So wish her the best. Want nothing but the best for her. But sometimes in life you go different ways. And sometimes you get blindsided by those different ways. And it just happens. So it's a long process. And it happened. And, you know, it was all finalized recently. Depends on how you define recently with the way time flies. But anyway, it's a long process. You know about all this. So here I am, right, out here in this world, living this gypsy nomad life that I have lived. You know, look, I got the word gypsy tattooed on my body in two different places. I mean, it's just kind of how I am. And I've often tried to want to be different. Like at my age now, at 48, almost 49 here in a couple of weeks, I've just kind of embraced that I am how I am, and I'm not going to change, right?
Nor should you.
Well, there are things, like every now and then I talk to God, and I'm like, God, well, like every night, you know, I pray every day, often through the day. But sometimes you have that real talk with God, like that real talk with God. Like, God, this is really messed up. Like, I'm really messed up. Like there are things that you just want to change. Like, I'm of the firm belief that not all of, not everything, like, if you get to go to heaven, if you believe in Christ as I do, and you believe that he is the way, the truth, and the life, and he is the gateway through which you go to heaven, as Christians believe, and he has redeemed you, that not all of you is going to heaven. Like, there's some parts of you that ain't going. there's some aspects you're going to have to change to fit in.
Right.
And we are on this struggling journey to be transformed inside to outside, right? You want to change on this planet, you know, in this life, right? We all want to be better people. And we want to live transforming lives. And you grow as time goes on. I like to believe that we become more patient the older we get. We certainly gain perspective, and with that comes some wisdom. We are a little bit more patient. We give less care to the absurdity of things, like those emails that come in. It's like, dude, I'm sorry that you took the time to type out 85 words. I'm really sorry that you felt the need to do that. Because at the end of the day, I wasn't doing anything to you. But you felt like the need to, like, I don't care, bro.
Also, I don't know you. I don't know you, so I don't care.
And I love it when people come at you and they're like, you've lost my respect. Well, I don't know you, so I wasn't asking for your respect. Like, if you respect me, that thank you. But I wasn't asking for it in the first place. You don't know me. And I don't think I grieved your spirit, you know, because you don't love me. Like, you can't grieve about me if you don't know me and love me. Grief is actually a love word, right? That's why we grieve over losing loved ones. It's a love word. You don't grieve over something you don't love. And, I mean, I hit a deer going through College Station, and the deer died in the middle of the road. I didn't even slow down. I was doing 75 miles an hour, and it boom, there it went. I didn't grieve over it. I mean, I plan on killing three more this season anyway, on purpose. So,
No grieving when it comes to the deer.
I mean, I'm not grieving.
No.
But at the end of the day, you know, you just get to that point where perspective is everything in the reality of life. And I want, you know, I want at the end of the day, you know, I talk about vision, passion, discipline, risk. I talk about history, identity, destiny, legacy. I want to be able to leave something behind. I do. But God, I've had so many fumblings and failings and frailties and faults that are out there. But you just get to a point where you're like, I'm me. I'm going to be me. I'm comfortable in my, I mean, I just burped on microphone right here.
There you go.
National television.
We're all comfortable.
I am, you know, I am how I am. To the point, I wish there was an Invisalign for life.
Oh, wow. I like that.
But there's not. I wish that we could just transform ourselves in 3 months. But we can't. It's a lifetime. It's a lifetime of tragedy, of success, of failure, of experience, of losing, winning. False expectations, hopes, dashed dreams, People come, people go, people live, people die, people are born, people reject you, they accept you. The life experience, right? It's just out there. And then sometimes you put yourself out there on a public forum and for the world to see, you know, you're in a marriage that maybe ain't so great, and you try to promote that marriage publicly in order to try to make the marriage better. Mm-hmm. And that doesn't work.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? Because at the end of the day, there's still a fault line underneath it that was there for a long, long time. And I think that's true about life too. We try to put our best self out there for the world to judge.
Well, and that falls in line with the whole Instagram social media.
Yeah.
We're only posting the highlights, the good parts of our days, not the bad, you know,
yeah,
those moments where you're having a breakdown or you're upset or you're mad or you're losing it over something, you know, it's like a reel.
And to that point, when I come out and I put a post about male suicide and how men don't go get help and they don't deal with their depression. Mm-hmm. You know, I've been very vocal about depression mm-hmm. over the years. Deal with it, have dealt with it, manage it my ways. But I talk about it, I'm vocal about it. People come and say, oh, well, you're running for governor in Texas. No. I am a flawed human being. Amen. And anybody that's out there that wants to try to portray themselves as not being that is simply lying. And, you know, if me putting a post out there that inspires a man to go out there and get the help he needs, if that costs me votes,
yeah,
then I'm willing to pay that price. Right?
Well, and you've always been public about the skeletons in your closet. You've never shied away from talking about going through depression,
all of it. Alcohol abuse.
Yeah.
Drug abuse.
Right.
Sex life. I mean, whatever. I mean, just stupid decisions
right.
that I've made in my life.
Yeah.
A Grapevine Jail. It's a great jail. If you're going to spend the night in the Metroplex on the state's dime, Grapevine is a good jail. They don't treat you like animals in there. North Richland Hills, not a great jail.
Okay. Noted.
Not so much. They kind of stack you in there. Mm. But, you know, it's not the Hilton. So anyway, Let's dig a little bit deeper into this. I think we're going to help some people in this episode. But you know what? You may not be able to fix your life, but you can fix your skin right now. Chamonix, I've told you about Samantha from Arcadia, California. She talks about her remarkable results. Talks about loving the Genucell plant, stem cell therapy. She says she's used it all over her face, under her eyes. It's cleared up the flakiness, even reduced her forehead lines. And someone even asked if she'd had work done. Nope, just Genucell by Chamonix. So the fine lines, the forehead wrinkles, the dark spots, the bags, the puffiness under your eyes, gone right before your eyes. And best of all, this guaranteed results in as little as 12 hours. Are you going to get your money back? It's simple. Just that simple. So get it. And get this, Genucell has now sold over 1 million products. It's for both men and women, people across the country. Once they try Genucell products, they're going to fall in love with it. They're going to buy them again and again. I use it under my eye. Doesn't leave the residue. I even use a little bit under my chunky chin right here, and it clears me up. Y'all, if y'all think I look rough now, y'all should see what I look like without the Genucell.
I'm going to start using that. Stu brought a whole box home.
Yeah, it's awesome.
I'm going to try it.
It really is awesome stuff. Like, you'd be rubbing cream on your face for days.
Give me all the serum.
Like, hours. Just put it everywhere. But I get 60% off on the Genucell packages. I could do that from now until Thanksgiving. If you go to lovegenucell.com/watchchad, that's lovegenucell, GENUCEL.com/watchchad, 60% off. Express shipping right now is free. lovegenucell.com/watchchad. Be right back. You know, at the end of the day, Lisa, I'm pretty proud of some things. You know, I always tell people, I say, you know, I can't explain my success that I've had in life, whatever it is, without using the vocabulary of the divine. Because there's no explaining what I've done and where I've come from and where I am today and the things that I believe God has given me and the platform he's given me. That being said, I've had a lot of time for some introspection. It's interesting, in the last year, because I've spent even more time on the road, alone, driving.
I was going to say, you really did uphold your promise, because remember at the beginning of the year, or I think it was last year, you said, I'm touring, but I'm not flying. We're only doing the bus thing. And I really can't believe that you've gone almost a full year of just bus tour.
Bus or truck.
Yeah.
I mean, you know, or caravan of vehicles.
Right.
We've done it. And then, of course, the campaign stuff. I mean, you know, I'm trying to hit every county in the state in some form or fashion. There's a lot of places you can't fly to.
Right.
In the state of Texas. And it's a waste of time. I mean, by the time we, you know.
Yeah.
You go to the airport and do all that stuff. So I've had some time to be introspective. And I've been living alone, right, for the last year. I've been living in a beautiful townhouse downtown Fort Worth for the last year. My friends, I got to give them a shout out, Zach and Jana Campbell, were very gracious to me when you know, got to a point where I was basically homeless. You see, people see you publicly and they think, oh, yeah. Mm-hmm. I mean, it was a rough year. It was a great year, but it was a rough year.
Yeah.
The last 12 months. So you're like, you're basically homeless. And you're living in a hotel, and they're like, hey, we have a house. It's empty. Go move into it. Pay the mortgage on it. If you want to buy it, buy it. If you don't. Just do it.
Yeah.
And so, you know, moved out of that, moved into a little small apartment, still in Fort Worth. And, like, I had to wrestle with that, too. Like, I'm like, is that, like, at a certain point in time in life, you're like, don't I want to be living on that big ranch
right
out there, you know, by the...
And I think people expect that too when they know that you're in the public eye and you obviously you're doing good for yourself. They probably assume you're living in this huge Glenn Beck mansion.
Yeah.
But
that's just not me. Like I just know that's not how I'm wired.
Well, and you're never home.
So
downgrading for you makes sense. You don't have a family. You don't have kids living with you now. You are literally on the road every single weekend. Yeah. So. To have a big space doesn't make any sense.
Yeah. Oh, and to be clear, to clarify something, you brought up kids. So I have four kids.
Right, but are grown.
We don't have any kids together. We a lot of people have that. Like we don't.
Oh, I thought you meant me and you. No, we definitely don't have kids together.
No, we don't yet. I will get the vasectomy reversed. If you can get the.
Whoa.
If you.
Whoa.
She just thrust her fupa.
I really did. My fupa. Yeah.
You get the stew reversed. I'll get the vasectomy reversed. Okay. You get your husband reversed. We'll deal with that. But anyway, I am.
But you and your ex don't have kids together.
We don't have any kids together.
So that's kind of a blessing.
That's a misconception.
Yeah.
There. A lot of people were under the. Because again, I've always hidden my kids. One, they want to be hidden.
Mm-hmm.
They don't want to be in the. Mm-hmm. Like, you know, my son, somebody went out and kind of trolled one of his social medias out there, and they tried to expose some things because of the political thing. They tried to expose some stuff, and
that's so wrong to do to a kid. How old's your son?
14, 15.
Yeah, that's
15
awful.
Yeah. So here's a kid who is crazy nerdy smart, right?
Mm-hmm.
Like he's nationally ranked in mathematics, and you know, kids, they get on social media and they play around with the different avatars and stuff, mm-hmm. and he did put the thing on there and said, yes, I'm COVID vaccinated or whatever, the little on your profile picture. Oh, people jumped all over that. So it's just a kid playing with the internet.
Of course, yeah.
You know. So I had, you have to tell your kids, say, hey, guys, you have to be careful what you do out there because of me, they're going to come after you.
Mm-hmm.
So I've tried to protect my kids. And for the most part, people have honored that. Although I know there's assholes out there, but my kids can handle themselves. I mean, you know, my daughters are, you know, they're older and got a great relationship with my kids. Love them. I'm very proud of them. But I've tried to keep them out of the light of that. So a lot of people have thought that she and I had kids together. We didn't. And also people interpret reality based off what they see on social media. So you're right. I don't have the kids at home. So I'm in an apartment and it's... You're helping me decorate it.
I can't wait.
Yeah. And you know what? We'll throw crap out and buy new crap,
mm-hmm.
which I know you love that.
Oh, I'm a purger. You better just, you know what? Make it easy for me and just you put a pile of what you want to keep in the corner and I'll get rid of the rest.
So when I moved in the apartment, like Allison, everybody knows Allison. Allison came in and I donated it into the townhouse before I moved into the apartment. I donated a lot of stuff. And that was good stuff, like brand new washer and dryer, refrigerator. I just went out and found people who needed it more than me.
Yeah.
And so I was like, here, you know, take it.
Yep.
And there were beds and mattresses and things. So I said, you know, I'm going to simplify my life as much as I know how. because there's so many things that I do. People keep coming at me. Like when the book, Am I Crazy, when it came out and I was doing all the media hits and everybody was going, you know, what do you do? You've got the talk show on Blaze. You're a comedian. You're a musician. You're an author. You do this, that, and the other. You know, what do you do? And I'm like, yes, all of it.
Yeah.
I do all of it. You know, gubernatorial campaign, all these things. You know, spokesperson for this company or that company. Shout out to American Hats. I mean, just all these different things that you do. And I was like, okay. And somebody told me, they said, who was it? Jim Carrey didn't tell me this, but there's a thing that talks about, that says whenever you get depressed, that is your, like your avatar that, and I'm paraphrasing, but he used the phrase avatar. He said, that's when you've faked it so much that your real self is saying, I'm tired of that.
Right.
Like, you can't do it. And so I have people who know me very well, and they've said, look, you got to get back to doing the things you really enjoy doing, the things you really love doing, and eliminate. And I said, well, the hard part is I really love doing everything I do. Right?
Or you wouldn't be doing everything you do.
Yeah. But I do add things on. Like, you know, right in the middle of all of this, we built chadprather.com. And so now I'm back to making sure that my comments and commentary and you know, remarks are put at chadprather.com, which I encourage people to go and, again, give me your email address. So you know, I'm always adding more stuff because I don't feel like my life really began until I was 42 years old.
So
professionally.
Right. Right. Okay. Yes.
Professionally. I've done a lot of things in my life. Third world countries, humanitarian work, mission work, medical work.
Pastoral work.
Pastoral work.
Yep.
You know, I've worked in ministries, nonprofits. I've worked in the corporate world. You know, I've done all these different things, but I was never fulfilled. Mm-hmm. And like Colin Hay, the lead singer of Men at Work, he's got a song called Waiting for My Real Life to Begin. Like, that was like my theme song. It's like, I'm just never going to fulfill dreams.
Well, do you think that you worked all those different jobs because you were trying to find what you wanted to be fulfilled by?
I was never like, I want to do something new all the time.
Right.
And so, you know, different people, my ex being one of them, said, you'll never be satisfied. Well, that can be a blessing and a curse, mm-hmm. right? There's part of me, I don't ever want to be satisfied, mm-hmm. but I want to be content. Mm-hmm. You know, I want to keep pursuing, but I don't want to, I want to be content with it. But I'm working on that. Those are kind of things I'm working on. And just simplifying right now. And so I just wanted to get introspective as we're heading into the holiday season.
Well, and this is
people
the time.
People need to think about stuff.
Yeah,
like this.
And this is the time that, you know, we talk about slowing down, not yeah. doing too much, like just being with your family, yeah. chilling out, relaxing, not going. But I don't think people realize that while this whole divorce was going with you, like you were still doing all of these things. And so yeah. to come on and tape 3 and 4 shows at a time sometimes and then go and travel to different towns and cities throughout the week takes a toll on you on top of like everything that's going on behind the scenes that people don't know.
Yeah.
So,
a lot.
You know, kudos to you for not actually having a total mental breakdown. Thank you, Chad.
Yeah. Well, you know what can help you with all of this if you're dealing with these crazy things? Headspace.
Hey.
Are good your thoughts transition. Running in endless circles in your mind with the stresses of the last year? It's more important than ever to practice living healthier and happier lives. So what if a few minutes was all it took to change your relationship with stress and anxiety, transforming your life for the better? That's the power of meditation with Headspace. Our thoughts can be confusing enough. Meditation doesn't have to be. Headspace is your convenient dose of meditation, mindfulness, and sleep exercises to relieve stress and anxiety and help you get a good night's sleep. All in one app that makes it easy to catch your breath and make time for your mental health. It's one of the most science-backed meditation apps in the world, proving that meditation works. A study proves that in just 2 weeks, Headspace can reduce your stress by 14%. So find some Headspace at headspace.com/Chad. Get 1 month free of their entire meditation library. This is the best Headspace offer available, so go to headspace.com/Chad today. That's headspace.com/Chad. And we'll be right back. I'm eating the hell out of these cookies.
You really are. I'm glad you like them.
They're so good.
I'm just moisturizing my hands over here.
Chamonix.
Sure, yeah. The wrinkles are disappearing in front of my eyes.
I love how Chris, both with the way he spells things, Like in emails?
Yeah.
Or the way he says, he just like drops certain syllables out of the word.
It's just his way.
He just creates a whole new word. Chamois?
Wait, what? How is it pronounced again?
Chamonix.
Chamonix.
Mm.
That was good,
you
huh?
Eating Oro?
Hey, you know what? My aunt asked me to bring dessert for Thanksgiving this week, and I said I'll bring the white chocolate covered Oreos.
Let's go.
I did. I buy in bulk.
Yeah, you do.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Mm. Hashtag that. Get it trending. Mm.
What?
What?
White Oreos. Oh, my gosh.
That's racist. Why is the white over the... Okay.
Oh. Oh.
Wow. Triggering.
Wow. Hope everybody... You know, I love Thanksgiving.
I do, too.
I love the food. I like... That's my favorite meal.
What's your... We talked about this last year. What's your favorite...
I like the turkey. I love turkey.
But what's your favorite side, though? We talked about this last year.
I love it all. I love dressing. I love, you know, cornbread dressing. I love the gravy.
The green bean casserole.
I love green bean casserole. Yes. I don't like sweet potatoes, so sweet potato casserole, man.
Yeah, no, I can't talk to him.
I don't do sweets, Chris.
That's just, I can't, unrelatable.
What'd you say, Kayla?
Chris doesn't like green bean casserole.
Oh, yeah. I love green bean casserole.
Chris, fire him.
And cream of mushroom with French cut green beans and the
yeah.
on top. Yeah.
So good.
But I love, like, I make a really good macaroni and cheese.
Mm-hmm.
Macaroni and cheese is legit.
Mac and cheese, yeah.
You know, mashed potatoes and again, the giblet gravy I love. I don't like cranberries. Yeah.
Can't relate.
You like it?
I like the Ocean Spray jellied cranberries. Oh, yes, she said it. She said it.
Oh, you? Yeah. You, the things that people don't say, you say. That's what I love about Lisa
Give me
Page.
The canned yeah. cranberries, please.
Yeah, she let the silent things come out of her mouth.
That's right.
I love that meal. And Allison cooks it well. Everybody
I love
Allison.
That you spend it with Allison, with all of your dogs together. Because isn't Pepper and Allison's dog related?
They're siblings. Yeah.
They're siblings. They came from the same litter.
Yeah.
Because Allison throws up TikToks all the time with the dogs.
Yeah.
And so
well, there's three of them.
Well, yeah.
So Jack and Zach and Jana, Jack and Zana. I call them Zana.
Uh-huh.
Zach and Jana. They have one, and the people who own my townhouse. And then I have one. Allison's got one. Right. And then shout out to Lone Star Bloodhounds, the Rikers out in Weatherford. That's they have these incredible dogs. They're the best dogs.
Pepper's getting huge, and
she's a monster.
Her ears are enormous.
Yeah. She's sleeps 23 hours a day. It's fantastic.
Oh, that's good.
My sweet baby. And Dolly, she's doing good. She's back from reform school. And yes, let's settle it now. Cash and Willie and June are at the other home. Okay.
Mm-hmm.
We didn't want to split up those three dogs.
Mm-hmm.
And so they stayed with her. So people say, where's Willie? Where's Willie? Where's Willie?
Yeah, people are so worried about Willie.
Willie's perfectly fine.
Uh-huh.
We just didn't want to split those three dogs up. So that's where it is. I don't know. Enough about me. Let's do a TikTok, Chris. Do it.
When my ex-husband and I were in college, we went to the grocery store one afternoon. We were in the yogurt aisle, and I was getting some yogurt. Down the other side of the aisle comes this woman who could best be described as Mama June's long-lost sister. And her cart is full of items that could best be classified as the old Roy of people food. Tombstone pizzas, pizza rolls, corn dogs, taquitos, enough Mountain Dew and Pepsi to drown Noah's Ark. And Honey Boo Boo Child with her said, Mom, can we have some yogurt? Child seemed nice, and hey, he was interested in getting something nutritious unlike the rest of that sludge that is in the cart. But Mom wasn't having it. She said, we aren't getting any of that liberal yogurt stuff. Liberal yogurt stuff. This was in Terre Haute, Indiana. Are we surprised? And at the Kroger on Wabash Avenue.
There you go. Some of this is liberal. First of all, I would like to say that there was a fat lady who was in the grocery store and she was eating pizza rolls and she was going to go home and eat a bunch of old Roy of human food. Mm-hmm. And they want, like, this chick doesn't move her neck when she moves. You know, like, there's like nothing there. Like, and maybe this is one of those liberal things that we do. We just do not move our feet and we talk through our nose. La, 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 la.
Maybe she needs to invest in some Tombstone pizzas to loosen up.
You know what?
Good Lord.
You know what? Come have some of my old Roy Oreos.
Yeah, exactly.
You know? I mean, who knows? You know, to each their own. I mean, my God, are we going to dictate everything people put in their bodies now, whether it's a blah, blah mandate or their food or whatever
else? Well, yes. And then we're going to go on TikToks and we're going to bitch about them so we can go viral. All right, Sue.
The fat woman didn't want to eat your liberal yogurt.
Yeah.
She didn't want her kid being indoctrinated through your weird fungus that you like to ingest. Whatever.
Stay in your own lane, babe.
Yeah. You're not getting any of that liberal yogurt. We're going over here and get some ice cream.
Yeah.
Not Ben and Jerry's, because they're liberals.
I have to agree with her on that one.
Yeah.
They're kind of, meh.
Ben and Jerry?
Ben and Jerry, yeah.
Super liberal.
I know. That's why, I
woke
mean.
Woke ass liberals.
Yeah, no.
Yeah.
No.
That was refreshing. I love to hear that woman talk. And I love her little zoom in thing when she's doing things like she's going to make her point.
Totally unnecessary to have that TikTok be more than 20 seconds long.
Yeah. Someone was in the grocery store and they were buying the same shit as me. Yeah. So I'm going to come home and be a social justice warrior for it.
Exactly.
Play another one. I can't get enough.
I'm going to say this one last time. Everyone cover your noses because I am not getting COVID because I want to see Harry Styles in concert. Next month. Everybody cover the nose.
Styles.
I swear to goodness gracious, if I get COVID the week that I'm supposed to see Harry Styles, I don't know what I will do. But I don't want to, I don't even want to think about it. So cover the nose.
Cover your nose with your mask, kids. That's right.
Oh, what I wouldn't give to see a kid just cough all over her. Just right there in the front. Blech! Yeah, exactly.
I'm a biohazard. There's a part two?
No, there's not.
Oh, yeah. Play part two.
All right, so for today's do now. Wait, oh my God, look at this. On a scale of 1 to Harry, how has your week been so far? See, Harry Styles.
Yeah.
What? How? Where is this school?
That's a teacher. Don't let your kids go to college. They come out like this person.
Right.
My God.
These teachers are the ones that are supposed to be teaching class. Like, that was college? Do we know where?
No, those are kids. Those are
high school.
Kids.
Oh, Lord.
Ah, well.
I feel bad.
Maybe they got their shit figured out. Obviously, you've been listening to me. I don't. So, maybe this lady's got it all planned
out.
Well,
surely. She listens to Harry Styles. Her life is set.
You know what? I'm single. Maybe I'll go find me go get some of that liberal yogurt. Find me a nasal bitch, I'm down. Y'all hang tight. We'll be right back. All right, folks, we will not have another episode of the Chad Prather Show until next Monday. That's right. We want you to enjoy your Thanksgiving holiday. We're going to do our best to enjoy ours. Mm-hmm. Lisa?
Yeah?
Big plans?
Nope.
Just going to chill.
I'm going to have to make...
Those are the best plans.
Exactly. Thank you.
Yeah. I will be alone, sucking my thumb, rocking back and forth in the corner of my little hovel apartment. Humming Jesus Loves Me it's going to be great, man. Life's what you make it, and it's a blessing. It really is. Chris, Kayla, you really are my favorite person. And let's get together, Kayla. Let's go get some booze. we could go get some booze and get some booze. You know what I'm saying?
I love her. Sure.
Sure, why not?
Kayla's
what kind
down.
Of booze are we talking about getting? Anyway, I love y'all. Go to watchchad.com. It's where the fun stuff is. Get that Christmas shopping done. You know where to go. Also, chadonblaze.com and sign up for a subscription to BlazeTV. Thank you, Lisa, for coming on, and we will talk to you next Monday. Happy Thanksgiving.
Happy Thanksgiving.
God bless you.
Gobble, gobble. Gobble, gobble.